Praise God, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Hallowed be his name. His kingdom come. His will be done in each of us as it is in heaven. Hallelujah. Those are not meaningless words, brothers and sisters. It's so funny. People, you know, lots of denominations, they do that, get up there and keep reciting what is commonly known as the Lord's Prayer. But actually, it was the prayer that the Lord gave to the disciples to pray. The Lord's Prayer is actually John chapter 17, when he talked to the Father, is one of the prayers that we have recorded of the Lord. You know, thank the Lord that there is a recorded prayer. John chapter 17, where the Lord prayed to the Father. But the prayer that he gave the apostles, brothers and sisters, is an outline for how we should pray. And that section is something you guys hear me say many times, and people just don't, you know, take it to heart and understand. Let thy kingdom come, let thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Brothers and sisters, in heaven, there's no sin, no sickness, no disease, no lost people, no wicked people, no evil people. Everybody is a saint of God or an angel, or the Lord is there. Hallelujah. So God, the Lord Jesus, told us to pray that God's kingdom and God's will be done on earth as it is in heaven, brothers and sisters. And I submit to you that you have to do the will of God and let his kingdom come in your life before you can worry about what is going on out there in the world, brothers and sisters. Amen. Amen. Thank God Almighty. You know, brothers and sisters, I want to show you and tell you those things, and the Lord wants to give us all kinds of wisdom and take us on up higher. But we have many among us, brothers and sisters, who have not allowed the kingdom of God to come in them and be in them as it is in heaven. Hallelujah. First, you got to get born again. The first step is to be born again. Jesus said, John chapter 3, verse 3. You know, in the Philippines, when you say, you know, they'll ask you, what religion are you? Well, for one thing, the word religion is a bad word to me. It means a system of man-made rules to try to, you know, to become like God and make your way to heaven through your own works. But they'll say, what religion are you? Because the Philippines is about 89% Catholic and about 2 or 3% Muslim and 2, 3 or 4% cults. Lots of cults in the Philippines. Lots of Mormons, Jehovah's Witnesses. There's another church called Iglesia Ni Cristo. Philippines is about 4 or 5% born-again Christian, brothers and sisters. The pastors there try to tell me, oh, that's not right, that the, you know, the government's fudging the number. The number's more like 10 or 20%. Even so, let's just go. That's why I'll say, okay, let's go in between, let's say about 10%, just for the sake of discussion. Let's take it halfway. Brothers and sisters, those Filipinos will ask me, what religion are you? And I'll say, oh, I'm a Christian. What do you mean a Christian? You know, I'm a follower of Jesus. Oh, you're born again. Oh, you're a born again Christian. You're born again. See, they think it's a denomination. It's a cult. It's a religion. It's a group, born again. 99% of people that I meet, especially in the Philippines, even in the States, they don't know that Jesus said, you know, lots of times we love to quote John 3:16 and all that. We don't say that. Oh, Jesus said, you know, because lots of people, even that don't believe, you know, about maybe they say, you know, they've heard something all about Paul or whatever, but they believe that, hey, they believe at least that Jesus was a prophet. Jesus was a wise man. Jesus was, you know, a special person. Even if they don't have not been born again yet, they don't necessarily believe the Bible. You hear about Jesus, they say, oh, you know, there, that's a, it's a whole nother level of authority and respect and, you know, and attention that you can get from people. When you say the Bible says, you know, sometimes, oh, that's under the law, oh, that's in the Old Testament, oh, Paul said that, you know, even though that's not true. It is true to say, oh, that's under the law, you know. And so there's lots of qualifications when we say, oh, the Bible says, you know, to stone somebody if they did this and that. You know, and they say, well, you know, that's under the law. That's true. That's all this other roundabout discussion. But when you said, Jesus said, or in Philippine, you know, in Cebuano, in their area where I'm at, it's Masulti, Si Jesus, you know, Jesus said, that's the language, that's what you say. When you say that, boom, you get people's attention. Jesus said. You don't have to give people Bible verses. I quote Bible verses because, you know, I want to be on record that, hey, that you guys can go look it up. And B, hey, I'm a servant of God. Hey, God's inspiring me and, you know, calling to my remembrance the Bible verses. Flowing in the power of the Holy Spirit as God is leading me. It's a confirming. And then, hey, you could go look it up. But when you're talking to non-believers on the street, you start talking about, you know, and lots of people, they've been, you know, they're like a Jehovah Witness. You know, they got this program, Roman Road. It's like, oh, in Romans chapter 10, verse 9. You know, you don't need to tell non-believers that. You know, you just say, Jesus said, Jesus Christ said, except a man be born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. And that just happens to be, for FYI for you guys, John chapter 3, verse 3. Jesus said, Masalti si Jesu Christo, that's in the Cebuano. Jesus said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whomsoever shall believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the light. No man comes to the Father except by me. That's another great one to use with Catholics. Jesus said, don't say, oh, John chapter 14, verse 6. Now, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by me. You know, I want to do a whole teaching about the words of Jesus. As the centurion said to Jesus, you know, just say the word and my servant will be healed. But the Lord has just arrested me to even tighten it up and just say, Jesus said. Hallelujah. That's the title of this message from the Lord. God Almighty, Jesus said. Has he not said it? Will he not do it? As it says in the Old Testament, God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. And that's a different son of man. Not, he means that way, a son of Adam. In the Old Testament, he's a son of Adam. And we are all sons of Adam. As I made in that last video about the sons of God versus in the sons of Adam. Has he not a man? God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. Has he not said it? Will he not also do it? Is he not also able to perform those things that he says? And brothers and sisters, as another example, when they were in the boat and Jesus came walking across the water, it says they were afraid. They thought it was a ghost. And Peter said, Jesus, Lord, if it be you, bid me to come unto you. And Jesus said, come, in English. Bu in Hebrew, or you know, Aramaic, it's a variation of that word. You know, bu. And then, you know, in English, bu would be something that, you know, we attain to a spirit, ironically. So Jesus said, boo, but not boo. He said, boo. And then he was probably yelling because it was a storm. And then Peter walked out there. Why? Because Jesus said and commanded him, come. Jesus said, come. And he did. He walked right out there on the word of Jesus. Hallelujah. So, you know, we could take that on to the next level. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You could take that on to the next level to talk about any topic. Let's go on. We're talking about, you know, as I started this video, you know, I was saying in the beginning of this video, you know, God wants to take us to the top of the mountain. You know, I keep trying to run up the mountain, then I have to loop back around and come back. Then I try to get people in the middle of the mountain and take them up higher. You know, there are people that are at the level of, you know, unity among the brethren. And then there's lower people down at the bottom of the hill that are at John 3:16 and John 3:3. What I just been quoting, you know, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whomsoever shall believe with him should not perish but have everlasting life. They're down there at salvation. They're on the bottom of the mountain. There's people that's not on the mountain that are trying to get on the mountain. You know, we got to get people on the mountain, brothers and sisters. That's why I need your help. I need your help. Help me to do God's will, which is to let his will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Well, everybody's saved. Everybody's healthy. Everybody's walking in glory. Hallelujah. Not sinning, walking sanctified. Hallelujah. Just like what it is in heaven. Think about what's going on in heaven. Go read your Bible. Go read Revelation. See what's going on in heaven. Hallelujah. Everybody there's praising God. The angels are praising God. The four living creatures, which are a different class of angels. There's different classes of angels, and that's another video. They're going around in circles and saying, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah, giving praise and honor and glory to God. Hallelujah. You know, the 24 elders are casting their crowns and the angels are singing. The hallelujah choir. The people are singing, worshiping God. The saints who's gone on before us are there. The Old Testament saints are there since the time that Jesus led captivity captive and led them into the gates of heaven. And then those who have fell asleep before us, as Paul says, a euphemism in the New Testament for dying. All, as Jesus used the expression about Lazarus and Paul used the expression talking about people who died before the rapture, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. Jesus used it, as I said, about Lazarus, John chapter 11. They've gone on asleep. They're on there. They're in their spirit body, in their spirit man, spirit form, there with the Father in heaven at the throne of God, praising His name. Hallelujah. That's what it means, let His will be done on earth as it is in heaven, that we're praising God and worshiping God and going around saying, hath God not said? Jesus said. Hallelujah. That's what you tell people when people, you know, come up to you and say, well, guess what? There's supposed to be some tsunami here. There's supposed to be a tsunami coming here, wiping out the East Coast or the West Coast. Then what do you tell them? You say, Jesus said, John chapter 14, when you're talking to Christians, but to the world you tell them, Jesus said, let your heart not be troubled. You believe in God, you believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I would not have told you. But I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am you may be also. Hallelujah. There you'll be forever with Him. Hallelujah. Jesus said, let your heart not be troubled. Jesus said, and then when they start talking about all the things that's going on, about maybe some Ebola and maybe some, you know, problems where these communist New World Order people are stirring up, you know, racial tensions, trying to cause a civil war, trying to cause chaos, trying to stir up hate and discontent and chaos, what the devil does, doing the work of the devil, all you know, anybody that's a racist on any race, whether they be black, white, Hispanic, whatever they may be. You got La Raza, Hispanic racist group that wants to start a revolution and take over the world for, you know, Hispanic people. You know, that's straight from the devil. All of the things that's going on, Ku Klux Klan, Black Panthers, it's all straight. It's all hate. It's all the devil. It's to create chaos and violence and to kill, steal, and destroy. But you know, we're all one in Christ, whether you be Jew, whether you be black, white, Hispanic, Native American, or from India, Asia, whatever you are, we're all one in Christ. So when someone starts telling you about Ebola and all that, tell them, Jesus said, be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. Hallelujah, Jesus has overcome this world. Jesus said, I have overcome this world. He said, be of good cheer, I have overcome this world. Hallelujah. Jesus is with us. You know, when people says, well, I don't, you know, I get the probably one, you know, I'd say, always say this, but, you know, about what the most number one message I get. But one of the most number one messages I get is people saying, I think the Lord's, you know, it's, they won't say it in the King James word, but they'll say, the Lord's forsaken me. He's not with me. He's gone away. I don't know what I've did, but the Lord's not with me. You know, I'm in the darkness. I'm in the valley and I'm by myself and God's not with me. And then I tell them, but Jesus said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. I'll be with you always, even to the end of the age. Jesus said. Let's just flip it around and look at it from the other way. Why are you calling Jesus a liar? What did I quote from the Old Testament? What does it say? God is not a man that he should lie, nor a son of man that he should repent. Has he not said it? Will he also not do it? Is he not also able to perform those things that he says? Praise God. Jesus said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. I'm with you always, even to the end of the age. He said, let your heart not be troubled. In my Father's house are many mansions. I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am you may be also. If it were not so, I would not have told you, he said. Jesus said, John chapter 14. Jesus said, be of good cheer. I've overcome the world. Hallelujah. You say, oh, you know, we need to go vote. We need to get active. We need to do this. We need to do that. We need to do this. And Jesus said, my kingdom's not of this world. His kingdom is not of this world. Jesus said, my kingdom is not of this world. Why are you worried about the kingdoms of this world? Jesus said, when he was in the Garden of Gethsemane, he said, the God of this world comes and I have no part of him. You know, it's his hour. When they came to arrest Jesus, he said, you know, I haven't done anything, but it's your hour. It's his hour. It's the hour of darkness. Hallelujah. As a type of the tribulation. People say, oh, there's no pre-tribulation rapture. But Jesus said, Luke chapter 21, verse 36. He said, watch always and pray that you be counted worthy to escape these things. He just got through saying about the tribulation, escape these things and stand before the Son of Man. People say, oh, that, you know, there's no pre-tribulation rapture. There's nothing you can do. But Jesus said, Revelation 3:10, because you have patiently kept my word, I will keep you out of the hour of temptation that will come upon all the people of the earth, a.k.a. the tribulation period. There's those who believe that every greasy gracer, every person that ever said a prayer when they was 10 years old, said the sinner's prayer, been living like the devil ever since, these greasy gracers say they're going to heaven. They're going in the rapture, pre-tribulation rapture. But Jesus said to one church out of seven, Revelation 3:10, because you have patiently kept my word, or in King James, because you have kept the word of my patience, I will keep you out of the trials and the hour of temptation that will come upon the whole earth, because you have kept the word of my patience. Those who have not patiently kept his word will not be kept out of the tribulation. As is, I'm looking at the other side of what the Lord said for those who are greasy gracers. I just talked about people that don't believe in the rapture. Now I'm talking about those who believe that everybody's going in the rapture, even if they look like they're a Christian or they look like they went to church. But Jesus said, Luke chapter 21, verse 36. Let's look at it from the other side. Jesus said, watch and pray always that you be counted worthy. Be counted worthy to escape these things and stand before the Son of Man. If saying the sinner's prayer by itself and doing not being a doer of the word may make you worthy, Jesus would not have said, watch and pray always. Watch therefore and pray always that you be counted worthy. He didn't say pray one time, believe that I died for you. He said pray always that you be counted worthy to escape these things and stand before the Son of Man. To go in the rapture is not the same as being saved, obviously. Jesus said in Matthew chapter 25, there are 10 virgins, 5 are wise and 5 are foolish. 5 did not have enough oil. 5 did have enough oil. 5 entered into the marriage supper, into the wedding, and the door was shut. And when the other 5 came to the door and knocked after they went and got oil, after the wedding party had departed, a.k.a. the rapture, when they stood and knocked on the door, Jesus said, Jesus is the one telling that parable. He answered the door and said, I don't know you. I never knew you. I never knew you. And closed the door. They didn't go into the wedding supper. He closed the door in their face. Jesus said, I never knew you. Continuing about greasy grace. People that think you can live like hell and go to heaven all your life. Matthew chapter 7. Jesus said, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven. People that said, Lord, Lord, they said the sinner's prayer. They called him Lord. Jesus said, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father who is in heaven. Jesus said, I'll say to them, depart from me, I never knew you, you workers of iniquity. Jesus said, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven. Tell them Jesus said it. You don't say, well, the Bible says, or, Jesus said it. Tell them Jesus Christ, the Son of the Most High God, said it. Tell them it's words from the Lord. When you're speaking the word of Jesus, you're speaking the power of God through the power of the Holy Spirit into this world, into the ears of people, down into their heart, where Jesus said that the Holy Spirit would bring conviction. John chapter 16 and 17. Jesus said that the Holy Spirit would bring conviction of sin on this world. When you speak his words, Jesus said, don't think in advance what you're going to say to people. But he will speak to you what to say. He'll tell you what to say. He'll lead you what to say. That's why I don't have notes when I make my videos. Because the Lord Jesus said he would tell me what to say. He said, don't plan and rehearse in advance what you're going to say. I'll give you what to say. Hallelujah. Those who are led by the Spirit, these are the sons of God. The Bible says, Romans chapter 8, verse 16. Hallelujah. Verse 14 and verse 16. Verse 14, those who are led by the Spirit, these are the sons of God. Romans 8, 14. Praise God. Praise God through whom all blessings flow. Praise God, All you creatures here below, praise God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Hallowed be His name. Blessed be His name. Praise Jesus for what He said. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus for what He said. You know what He's going to say? When the Lord Himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of God, and the trump of God, and the voice of the archangel. You know what the Lord Jesus is going to say? Just like He said in Revelation chapter 4, verse 1, just like He says to the two witnesses in Revelation chapter 11, He's going to say, come up here! He's going to call me and you by name. Just like He called Lazarus. Lazarus, come forth. You know, it's been famously mentioned by many preachers. If He hadn't said Lazarus, all the people would have come forth out of the grave. He said, Lazarus, come forth with me and you. He's going to say, Patrick, come up here. You'll hear your name. You know, brother Gary, come up here. Praise God Almighty. Hallelujah. Hallowed be His name. Hallelujah. His kingdom come, His will be done in me and you as it is in heaven. Praise God. Hallelujah. Give Him the glory. Hallelujah. Let's go up to the top of the mountain and commune with God. He's waiting there for us. Let's go on up the mountain now. Let's stop clowning around with all these doctrines. As I've mentioned many times, and the Lord has given me that, one-liner for it. Stop looking at the Bible through your doctrine, through the lens of your doctrine. Look at your doctrine through the lens of what Jesus said. Hallelujah. Go on what Jesus said. You know, even though all the other Bible is the Word of God and there's all those doctrines and stuff, we can go back and forth on all that. But Jesus said, God spoke, let there be light, and there was light. Jesus is God. The Bible says, great is the mystery of godliness. That He was manifested in the flesh. You know, seen of angels, taken up in glory. Great is the mystery of godliness. Hallelujah. The Bible said He is the exact express image of God. Hallelujah. He is God. Praise God. The Lord said unto my Lord, sit at my right hand until I make thy enemies thy footstool. That's from Psalm 110. But you know what? Jesus said that text. Jesus quoted that text. When the Pharisees came to Him and He said to them, who do you say is the Messiah? Jesus said, who do you say is the Messiah? And the Pharisees said, oh, He's the son of David. That's why when the people cried out to Him, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy. That's what one of the expression names they had for the Messiah, that man had made up for the Messiah. Jesus, thou son of David. The root and offspring of Jesse. Jesse is David's father. Jesus is the root and offspring of Jesse, the father of David. So Jesus asked them, who do you say is the Messiah? And they said, oh, He's the son of David. And Jesus said, well, why did David, the same guy you're talking about, David, speaking by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, said, my Lord said unto my Lord, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies your footstool. If David then called Him Lord, how is He His son? That's what Jesus asked the Pharisees. And it said, they didn't know what to say. They stopped asking Him questions because Jesus said, if David called Him Lord, then how is He His son? Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah. Praise His name. He's God. Hallelujah. God in the flesh. Worship Him and praise Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. May the Lord give you eyes to see and ears to hear what Jesus says to His church. Hallelujah. That's what Jesus said in His word. He who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit said to the church. Jesus said it in Revelation chapter 2 and 3, and He said it in the Gospels. When He would tell a parable, He'd say, he who has an ear, let him hear. You need to get on your knees right now and say, Lord, give me ears that I may hear. The problem is lots of people are thinking cardinal. Ooh, I'm not deaf, I can hear. That's what the Pharisees said. You know, there was a blind man, they could see. You know, it's kind of what it's talking about in the song about the amazing grace, and I was blind, but now I see. That's straight out of John chapter 8 when Jesus, put the mud on the eyes and spit, and then the guy could wash his eyes in the pool of Siloam, and he could see. And then the Pharisees was asking him, how is it you could see? He said, I don't know. I was blind, but now I see. You know, and then when he came to Jesus, Jesus asked him, Jesus only revealed Himself to a few people. Only to a few people. people that really loved him. He revealed himself to that blind man because that blind man refused to deny the Lord like his parents denied the Lord. His parents were afraid, but this blind man was not afraid to declare that Jesus was somebody more than a prophet. Nobody's ever opened anybody's eyes that were blind. So they kicked him out of the synagogue. They kicked him out of Judaism. So he went out and he saw Jesus. And Jesus said, hey, do you want to know who's the Messiah? And the guy who was blind who could see said, yeah, I would love to see the Messiah. I would worship him. And Jesus said, he it is who you're talking to now. And he began to worship him. And Jesus said, blessed are those who are blind because they can see. And those who think they can see are blind. And then the Pharisees were there. Oh, are you trying to say we're blind? Yeah, Jesus was saying they were blind. Jesus said, because you say you can see, that's why you're being judged. Because you say you're not blind, but yet you can't see. But Jesus is the Messiah. He's the Christ, the Son of the living God. Hallelujah. He is the, as it says in Isaiah chapter 9, the everlasting Father. One of the titles of Jesus from Isaiah is the everlasting Father. Hallelujah. Unto us a son is given, unto us a child is born. You know, go back and read that. I believe it's Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. His name is Wonderful Counselor. Everlasting Father. Some of the titles of Jesus. Yeshua, the Messiah. Hallelujah. Hallowed be his name. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. I'll tell you, I had lots of different sermons in my mind that the Lord's been dropping on me. I've been meaning to make videos about them. And then I was here and I was like, I don't, this happens to me. The Lord does it to me all the time. I was like, well, I don't know what I'm going to say. I've got several different things I want to, the Lord has dropped on me, wisdom. I want to go with it. Don't know which one. I don't feel led to go with any of them. And then the Lord has just led me, just get on here and start talking. And I'll give you the words to say, just like he said in the Bible. Don't think in advance what you're going to say. So I would advise you, read your, if you want to be led by the Spirit, read the New Testament over and over again. Just keep reading one chapter a day, if that's what it takes. Just keep reading the New Testament. And then when the time comes, as the Bible says, I hide thy word in my spirit that I might not sin against thee. Get the word. Get in that New Testament and read it. Brand new believers going back trying to read the prophecies in the Old Testament. Next thing you know, like I said, they're wearing a yarmulke trying to speak Hebrew. They found out they've got, they think they've got one drop of Jewish blood. Next thing you know, they're wearing a yarmulke and a prayer shawl. They're on the internet. And thousands of people think they know what they're that they're some kind of a Hebrew scholar. Go read, humble yourself and read the New Testament over and over again. Get it down into your spirit. And when the time comes, when you are in that position, God will have a river. As Jesus said, out of your belly would flow a river of living water. Hallelujah. That the Spirit of God would call forth his word out of your belly. Brothers and sisters, so I advise you, that's a whole other thing. As you know, if you guys who normally watch my videos, I have to repeat this for people that might not have seen it. Of course, we need to be baptized in the Holy Spirit. That's a separate event from salvation. When you're saved, you're sealed with the Spirit, and then you're baptized in the Holy Spirit with evidence of speaking in tongues. Acts chapter 2, Acts chapter 9, Acts chapter 10 and 11, Acts chapter 19, all these things. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 1 through 5. All these things, on and on and on, brothers and sisters, as I've made videos at nauseam to deal with people that look at the Bible through their doctrine instead of looking at their doctrine through the Bible, and they're bound up in religious spirit, and it's all carnal-minded. They have cardinal ears to hear, cardinal eyes to see, it's all cardinal, but it's not spiritual. As the Bible says, the letter of the law brings death, but the Spirit of the word brings life. Hallelujah. It's by the Spirit. Hallelujah. The Spirit quickens the word. The Spirit quickens us to be saved. It's the work of the Holy Spirit in this earth. Since the day of Pentecost until now, the Holy Spirit, that self same Spirit, is working in God's church so that we can boldly say, I can boldly say, you can boldly say, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by me. John 14, 6. Jesus said, except a man be born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. John 3, 3. Jesus said, John 3, 16. Jesus said those words. Jesus said, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whomsoever shall believe in him will not perish but have everlasting life. Jesus said it. Jesus said it. Jesus said it. Hallelujah. Praise be God most high, through whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all ye creatures here below. Praise God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Blessed be his name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You know, I've been, you know, sometimes there's a few people before when I start really preaching, like, oh, Pastor Patrick, he's mad. He's being mean. No, I'm not mad. I'm declaring the word of the Lord. I'm saying what Jesus said. And his spirit is giving me boldness to speak it. It's not I just have an idea. I believe. I know Jesus said it. You know, you can tell when someone speaks if they really believe what they're saying. You know, if they're playing or acting or being somebody else, putting on a show, they're a showman, clowning around, carrying on. And there's, you know, there's a time to joke and, you know, and all that. But there's a time to say, Jesus said, you must be born again. Jesus said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Don't call Jesus a liar. You know, lots of people. There's power in the name of Jesus. People are afraid. They can even be deniers and all that. But when they hear Jesus Christ, there's a holy fear that comes on people. That's what they say. Oh, God. Oh, you know, God loves everybody. God is. Start saying, oh, you know, generically God. Well, who's God? Are you talking about the God of Allah? Are you talking about some, generic God? What are you talking about? This word God? No, I'm talking about Jesus. In English, we say Jesus Christ, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Jesus Christ said, thus says the Lord Jesus Christ, except a man be born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. You must be born from above. Hallelujah. In modern words. Spiritually born again, regenerated, renewed by the working of the Holy Spirit in your heart. Hallelujah. Jesus said, those who believe on me have eternal life. Jesus said, those who have the Father, you know, you have the Son. You can't have the Son without the Father. You can't have the Father without the Son. Hallelujah. Jesus said, my Father and I are one. Jesus said, if you've seen me, you've seen the Father. That's also John chapter 14. If you've seen me, you've seen the Father. The Father and I are one. Do I believe in the Trinity? Yeah, whatever. I mean, doctrines are meaningless. Jesus said, if you've seen me, you've seen the Father. Yeah, Jesus is God. God the Father is God. God the Holy Spirit is God. People try to go through all this explanation. We don't need to explain all that to the world. What the world needs to know is they're lost and without hope in this world. And Jesus said, if you're not born again, the wrath of God abides on you. Jesus said it. John chapter 3. The wrath of God abides on those who are not in Jesus Christ. If you're not born again, the wrath of God abides on you, remains on you. That's what they need to know. Jesus said that. Jesus Christ, hallelujah. Praise God. Tell them Jesus said it. Don't be, as they say, mealy mouth, wishy-washy. Get filled with the Holy Spirit. Let the boldness and the power of God speak through you. Hallelujah. Let those letters in red come out of your mouth. Red means bold. Red means loud. Red means truth. Say it loud. Say it large. Jesus said, what I whisper in your ears, shout from the rooftops, he said. That's why those people, you know, these religious people, especially some women, in a Jezebel spirit. I've had a few message me. Oh, you know, Brother Patrick, you know, we just need to keep grinning. And, you know, like a Joel Austin, oh, just be sweet. And, oh, just keep smiling. We're going to win them with the sugar and all that. Jesus said, shout it from the rooftops. He didn't say go rub everybody's bellies and just keep patting them on the head. Jesus said, shout it from the rooftops. Jesus called the religious leaders of the day, the Pharisees. Jesus said they're a brood of vipers. Jesus called them a bunch of snakes. I mean, come on. People got the wrong idea about who's Jesus, what he said. Jesus got mad. He had, righteous indignation. Use whatever it makes you feel good. Whatever you want to say. God got mad. He still gets mad, even in the New Testament. Jesus got mad. Read Revelation chapter 2 and 3. His eyes are like fire. His word to every church, Jesus said to every church but Philadelphia, he said to the other seven churches, Revelation 2 and 3, repent! Repent. Jesus said repent to every church but the church of Philadelphia. The same one, Philadelphia, Revelation 3:10, in the same text, he said, because you have patient, Jesus said, because you have patiently kept my word, I will keep you out of the hour of temptation will come upon the whole earth to try all of people of the earth. Jesus said, that remnant, that bride without spot or wrinkle, those five wise virgins, Jesus said all of these things that you might have life and life abundantly. John chapter 10, verse 9 and 10. Jesus said the enemy comes to kill, steal, and destroy. Whether that be Ebola, whether it be racism on all sides, civil war and strife, whether it be wars and pestilences and all the things that the devil tries to do in this world, and we're living in a fallen world. But Jesus said, I have come that you might have life and life abundantly, life to the full. I quoted that before. Someone even messaged me and said, Jesus didn't mean, that you should be blessed financially. He just meant that you should be happy. No, Jesus said that you would have life and life to the fullest, in some translations, to abundantly in all things, that you would prosper in all things, the Bible says. In all things. In all things. Hallelujah. God told Abraham, the Father said, he told Abraham, I'll bless you to make you a blessing. Hallelujah. He blessed Joseph to be a blessing to the whole world that they didn't perish in the famine. Hallelujah. God blesses his people that they can be a blessing in this world. Hallelujah. Receive the blessings. Don't let nobody put this false humility and religion on you. God wants you to be blessed in the city and blessed in the country. Blessed going in, blessed coming out. Hallelujah. Blessing all things. We've been redeemed from the curse of the law, but we got the blessings of the law. Hallelujah. But not the curse. There's no better deal that's ever been even thought of. That's why Hebrews says that we have a better covenant than Israel has. Us New Testament born again Christians have a better covenant. Why? Because we have the blessings of the law, but not the curse. Hallelujah. We've been redeemed from the curse of the law. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We've been redeemed by the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach, by Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. He redeemed us. Hallelujah. 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 He's redeemed us. Let your heart not be troubled, Jesus said. You believe in God, believe also in me. Hallelujah. In my Father's house are many mansions. I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am you may be also. If it was not true, I wouldn't have told you, Jesus said. Hallelujah. Jesus is not a liar. He's not a man that he should lie. Hallelujah. Put your faith and trust in what Jesus said and proclaim and declare what Jesus said. I could go on and preach all day. I could talk about healing. I could be talking about being baptized in the Holy Spirit with a river of living water, as Jesus said, would come out of your belly. I could talk about all those things. Hallelujah. Every topic you want to. Jesus said the word. Why are you debating and fighting the word with all of your doctrines so that you can have a form of godliness but deny the power thereof? You're weak. Jesus was meek, but you're weak. Why are you weak? As Paul said, so many among you are weak and sick and die. They're falling asleep because they took communion unworthy. They're not sanctified. They're living in sin and unbelief, full of doubt and unbelief. That's why when they take the communion, it's bringing a curse on themselves, Paul said. Be of faith, be of good cheer. Jesus said, I have overcome the world. Get in faith. That's what Jesus told Peter when he came walking on the water. Then he started sinking. Jesus, he said, help me. Jesus picked him up and said, oh, ye of little faith, why did you doubt? That's what, even myself, listen, when I'm talking, I'm also talking to myself. But when I start talking to a bunch of y'all, I say, hey, when I think I'm doing bad, all I gotta do is start talking to some of you guys. I say, I'm not, those people don't have any faith. Jesus is gonna be saying that to us when he sees us in heaven. Oh, ye of little faith, why did you doubt? I wanted to use you to move all these mountains, and you didn't do it because you didn't have no faith, full of doubt and unbelief. You didn't believe me when I said, hallelujah, that I would never leave you nor forsake you. You didn't believe me when you said I was with you. If God be for you, who can be against you? Jesus said, if God be for you, who can be against you? Hallelujah. He's going to ask us, ye of little faith, why did you doubt my words, what I said? Why did you doubt what I said? God have mercy on all of us. May God have mercy on all of us. For we are weak. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Jesus said, the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. When Jesus was in the garden and he asked Peter, James, and John to tarry with him and pray with him for a little while because he knew he was about to be arrested. And they all fell asleep. And Jesus said, the spirit of you boys is willing, but your flesh is weak. The flesh is weak. I pray there's lots of you, your spirit's not even willing. It's not even the flesh. Your spirit is not willing. May you at least be, may God give you the grace and the wisdom to humble yourself and get to the point to at least that your spirit is willing. Even though we know we always wrestle against our flesh. And we'll never overcome our flesh in this life, brothers and sisters. But may you at least get to the point where your spirit is willing. Many of you, your spirit's not even willing. You sing and say, let thy kingdom come, but you fight for your own will. You're trying to do your own will, looking for revival, looking for God to use you for healing and all this stuff, but you're fighting to do your own will, not what Jesus said. I can go all night, brothers and sisters. I can talk all night. I started to say all day, but it's nighttime. I can go all night. Because the Spirit of the Lord, hallelujah, is leading me to keep going. Praise His holy name. Bless God. Hallelujah. Love you guys. You know I love you. That's why I'm making these videos. People get offended. I don't care. I'm speaking the truth from the Word of God. Let it go to your heart. Let the Holy Spirit deal with you. Don't let it go to your head. Let it go to your heart. Don't let it go to your head. You get mad at me. I don't care. I'm only speaking what the Lord. I got to answer to the Lord. I'm speaking what the Lord told me to say. You know, about every video I get one person that get mad. And say, hey, I don't care. I'm not a people pleaser. I'm not Joel Osteen. I'm not worried if I have 50, 100 million subscribers and all that stuff like some kind of clown that might be here on YouTube or whatever. I don't care. Or, you know, Joel Osteen and all that. I don't care. I'm not Robert Schuller. I'm not worried about the power of positive thinking and all those things. I'm just worried about what Jesus said. Hallelujah. And the Bible said James, the half-brother of Jesus, a.k.a. his real name is Jacob, just a FYI there, and I'm trying to use as many acronyms as I can, you know, just to make it cute. Jacob said, be ye doers of the word, not hearers only. Be a doer of the word, not a hearer only. Do what Jesus said. If you could just do what Jesus said. Without getting into all, you know, 99% of people, they want to go be, a high theologian. I'm a high theologian, you know. They watch some videos on a brain surgery. They might go to the hospital and try to push a brain, you know, a neurosurgeon out of the way and just take over. Maybe they've been watching a people's court or Law and Order. They're going to go down to the courthouse and straighten out a few judges and a few district attorneys and all that. You know, people are crazy. Just learn to just do what Jesus said before you can get into all these doctrines. Jesus said, except you become like a little child, you cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. Jesus said. Just get that part down. Jesus said to people, to the disciples, follow me. Follow me. And I'll make you fishermen. He didn't say follow the Catholic Church. He didn't say follow the Baptist Church. He didn't say follow churches. He said follow me. Follow Jesus. You'll be all right if you can follow Jesus. Just follow Jesus. Read the New Testament and be led by His Spirit. As John said, we don't need a teacher. We got the Holy Spirit. That's true. But God does make preachers. I'm just trying to point you. That's the difference. I'm not trying to teach you all these doctrines and all that stuff. What I preach by the grace of God is just straight up foundational truth. I'm not saying, hey, you need to do A, B, and C, and all this doctrinal, you know, digested and interpreted. That's what people want. People who are regular Christians are lazy. They'll say, what do I do about this situation, blah, blah, blah. Well, if you knew what Jesus said, you'd know what to do. If you just knew what Jesus said, just read your Bible and retained it by the power of the Holy Spirit in your mind, you would know what to do. Do what Jesus said. It's just that simple. That's what I'm saying on my videos. Jesus said this. Now put that in practice. You know, eat that, regurgitate that, you know, process what Jesus said. You know, if any of you guys ever, you know, took any education classes, you know, like education, like a teacher, or even a class in education, you would know there's different levels of learning. You know, I could sit here and memorize this book. That's why I talked about Jehovah's Witnesses and these Baptists who memorized the Roman road. They're just regurgitating what they read. It's not even that they understood what it meant and synthesized it and applied it to other levels. There's all these different levels of using information. You know, knowledge becomes wisdom. It's knowledge without wisdom. That's the simplest way to say it. They have knowledge without wisdom. I can memorize the whole Bible. You know that Stalin memorized the whole book of John. Stalin was supposed to be a priest in the Russian Orthodox Church. He ended up, of course, being killed and more. Stalin, second to Mao Zedong, Stalin killed like 40 million of his own people in the purges that he had. Old Joseph Stalin. But he had the book of John memorized. He had knowledge but no wisdom. He didn't apply it or understand it or say, hey, you know, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. So let's apply that, not just repeat it. Jesus said, you know, how do you apply it? Well, I need to follow Jesus. I need to get with Jesus and be his disciple and be his follower so I can. He's the way to the Father. He's the way to heaven. You know, you have to apply these things in your life. I better run, brothers and sisters. I've already been going on and on. Praise God. That's all I can say. I'm just waiting to hear from the Lord. You know, I guess I've been singing a song in every video. I got to sing one. You know, I'm not mad. People don't understand that. Maybe people that's in the flesh, they don't understand. It's the Spirit of God. You know, the song says, I have decided. I think I've sang it many times. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turning back. Let's follow Jesus. Well, let's do what he said. Let's simply just follow Jesus. 99% of people, you know, follow Jesus. Just follow Jesus. Just get that part down. Let's just get that part down first. Let's work on that part before we go on to talking about all these doctrines and stuff. Woo! Praise God, brothers and sisters. Praise God. I thank the Lord for the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord for His Holy Spirit that comforts us, guides us, and leads us into all truth and righteousness. As Jesus said, the Holy Spirit will lead us into all truth and righteousness. Praise God. I'm going to cut it off. I'm sure that, you know, I'm already up to 48 minutes. God bless you guys. I ask you guys to pray. I put this on here. Trying to make a separate video. I didn't really hear from anybody. You know, we're going to have a Christmas party for the orphans. We're going to have special feedings. We feed over 800 kids a week. We're going to have special feedings. I ask you guys to pray about that. And thank all those who have, you know, who are sponsors. You know, I have the Facebook group. If you ask to join the Facebook group, I'll add you. The link is below all of my videos. You can join the Facebook group. You can even make up an anonymous account if you don't want to be on Facebook. I post at least a couple of pictures every day, basically every day. You can see what's going on. If you want to sponsor an orphan, if you want to contribute for the feedings, whatever the Lord leads you to do. Sometimes we even built churches. We're planning on building more orphanages. I mean, you know, just whatever the Lord will lead and provide for, we're going to do it. You know, that there's never enough. Excuse me. We're looking at having a party with orphanage and then a party, you know, special food for the feedings of 800 kids. That's going to be a couple hundred dollars at least. I want to try to give out some little gift to every kid. You know, I don't know. You know, just something small, whatever we can afford. Of course, something for the orphans and all that, you know, so that's, you know, we need extra, of course, an extra budget for all that. By the grace of God, I already know the Lord will provide. I'm just sharing it with you, give you an opportunity to get involved if you'd like to. Praying about, I'm looking at really seriously coming up to Seattle. You know, it's cold in January. I've been praying about it. I ask you guys to pray about it. Please comment, talk to me. I know I have a huge group of viewers up there in Vancouver and Seattle and Portland area. I'm looking at flying into Portland because, oh, it's a mess up there at the Seattle airport. You have to take these shuttle buses and stuff, you know, and it's a real big hassle there. I think the Portland airport might be better. And then I have people there, too. By the grace of God, I rent a car in Portland and then drive, you know, see people in Portland and go to Seattle, then to Vancouver, then back down. I'm thinking, you know, if we stand along the coast, there's not usually too much snow. I think the road will be all right as long as you stay close to the coast. You know, it's on if you go up to the mountains there, it's snowing toward like Snoqualmie Pass and all that, east of Seattle and also from Portland. So I ask you guys to pray about it. I ask you to comment. Please message me, email me. My email address is below here too. It's neartochrist@AOL. It's below all of my videos. Let's make a plan. I know it's cold. I'm also looking at going to Florida. I ask you guys in Florida, lots of people in Florida. You know, so I guess after if I spend a couple of weeks up there in the Northwest, you know, I have to go to Florida to recover because I'm spending in the Philippines so long, you know. And then my wife has, you know, never really been in too much cold weather. So, you know, we have to go to two extremes there to thaw out when we come back. Praise God. And then I'm looking at going to Dallas. I guess it'll probably be the end of February, I'm thinking. And then I'll pass through Nashville. And then if it's the roads are clear, I'll try to head up to West Virginia and all that. I'm looking at doing that at the end of February. I'll be leaving here and moving, I guess. I'm not sure yet. Dallas area is what I'm looking at. I don't know. Praying about it. So I ask you guys to pray. Comments, please. Prayers. I appreciate all that. God bless all you guys. You know I love you all. And you know, we're, you know, myself, like I say, every time I make a video, it's for me too. You know, I'm preaching to myself. You know, a lot of people maybe don't know that. But, you know, any preacher that's worth his salt, or, you know, that's not a, you know, obnoxious, arrogant jerk. Any preacher that you talk to will tell you, yeah, it's, you know, the message is for me too, of course. I'm still human. You know, and then, you know, every once in a while I get someone comment and say, you know, something about, well, you know, you're not perfect. Well, I know. Nobody's perfect but Jesus. Paul wasn't perfect. If I waited until I was perfect, I'd never be able to preach. No one could. No, if we only had perfect preachers, there wouldn't be any. So, no, I can't be perfect to preach because I'll never be in this life. I'll never be perfected until I'm in heaven with Christ. No more able to sin. You know, when I get up there with the Lord. You know, when we all get to heaven, what a wonderful, glorious day that will be, the song says. God bless you guys. Love you. Love you all. And I thank all those who have been helping me, you know, with the ministry, with all the stuff in the Philippines, even my travels here in the States. Several people have helped me, you know, and sisters let me borrow the van and the RV. Same sister, Sister Elaine. You know, thank her for that. All the people that helped me. Sister Rosemary helped me with the first book. I'm working on the second book now. So praise God. Brother Andrew, you know, made the cover for the first book. He offered to help me make one for the second one. Also, we talk about the website. You know, before I had lots of volunteers to help do the website, the Church Firstborn. And Brother Sid and I talked, you know, we want to really do something more with the website, get it rolling. Sister Elaine has also been doing that. I know that she's busy. And there are some of you guys who are really, you know, professional computer programmers who could help us. And if you could please contact me too, if you're a professional computer programmer and you want to volunteer to help with the website, I'll put you in contact with Brother Sid. And, you know, let's get it really rolling and get it using. I'd like to get the chat rolling good. Maybe even have some live videos on there. We could have chat groups on there, a certain schedule for chats, like for people that's divorce recovery, you know, drugs and alcohol recovery, newly saved. Have like an hour a week. We have these different topics and people go in there and chat. We can even do some kind of chat room or like Google Hangouts or whatever. I don't know what all there is. Lots of different things. I don't know what's best. Looking for your help and ideas. Let's do it, brothers and sisters. You know, we're all a team. And let's get, you know, let's help. There's, like I said, those of you who have volunteered, you know, help in different areas. You can also do a chat, a live chat, whether it be video or just voice or whatever, or typing. You know, nowadays, let's do video. You know, like a Google Hangout or Skype or, you know, a group Skype or however you can do it. Let's do it and, you know, really interact with people more and let's help people, you know, face to face. God bless you guys.